Today we will discuss about the various temple architectures in Odisha. As we know, Odisha is the land of temples, in which the capital, present capital, that is Bhubaneswar, is known as the as the temple city of India. So, the architectural design of the Kalingan temples or the temples of Odisha, it is quite different, and as a result, the Kalingan school of architecture has been given a separate place in the temple architecture of India. Today we are going to study about the various temple architectures. So, first thing we should know that in India there are majorly three types of temple architectures according to the location or the division of ancient India. Ancient India was divided into three parts. First was northern India, which was called the Aryavrata or the home of the Aryans. Central India was known as Madhya Desha, and southern India was known as Dakshinapatha. So, accordingly, in northern India, the temple architecture that was prevalent was the Nagara style of architecture, followed by the Vesara style, mainly in central India, and the Deccan. And in south India, you had the Dravida style. So, these were the three major temple styles in India. Just we will go through the important features of these three temple styles, and then we will go to the Odissan temples. So, the first type of temple, that is the Nagara type temples, and the main feature of the Nagara temples is that their body, okay, that is curvilinear. Okay, so, and above the body there is a amlaka. Okay, so that is a large round cushion like element which separates the two parts. And this style was developed in the 5th century. Many of the temples you find in Odisha are heavily derived from this Nagara style. So, that is the Nagara style of architecture, temple architecture. Next, we have the Dravida style of temple architecture. So, it is basically the structure of the temple is pyramidal, and there are cupola form shikharas. And the best examples of the South Indian temples can be seen at Mamallapuram and Kanchipuram. The Vesara type of temples had the properties of both the Nagara style and the Dravida style. So, that is why they are also called the Central Indian temple architecture style or the Deccan architecture style, because initially the rulers of Deccan, they promoted it, and you will find the best of examples in Deccan. So, as we have already discussed, to a large extent, the Odissan type temple architecture, it belongs to the Nagara school with some variations. And because of these variations, the Odissan temples have a different place in the various temples of India. That is why they are known as the Kalingan school of temple architecture. And these distinct properties which separate them or give them a unique identity, they have been mentioned in the Shilpa Shastras. Now, if we come to the Odishan temples, mainly the Odishan temples are divided into three types. There are three types of Odishan temples, and they are the Rekha temples. Most of the temples you will find in Odisha belong to this category, the Rekha temples. The Pida temples and the Khakra temples. So we will elaborate these three type of temple architecture. Now any Odishan temple mainly consists of two major parts. One is called the sanctum or the vimana and the frontal hall or the mukhashala, that is also called the jagamohana. Okay, these two structures are internally linked and they make up a complete temple. As the Odishan architecture evolved, two other structures were also added to it, that is the Natamandira and the Bhogamandapa. So, this is basically the structure of a Odishan temple. These four parts. You can also go to the figure which is shown on your screen, which shows you the Kalingan architecture. The Rekha temples, the Pira temples and the Khakra temples. Next important characteristic of the Kalingan temples is the vertical projections, which are known as the Rathakas or the Pagas. In fact, depending on the number of Pagas, the temple architecture is named. So temples have been classified as Triratha, having three Pagas, Pancharatha, having five Pagas, Shaptaratha, having seven Pagas, and Navaratha, having nine Pagas. So now coming to the types of temples, as we have already discussed, maximum types of temples in Odisha belong to the Rekha type and very few are of the other two type, the Pida and the Khakra. Okay, mainly the Shakta Pithas, they are the Khakra type temple you will find. So the Rekha temples, they are mainly characterized by a curvilinear superstructure and it can be divided into four divisions from bottom to top. That is the Pista, the Bada, the Gondi and the Mastaka, or the Mastaka is also known as the Sira, the head. Okay, this is just like a human being, because the craftsmen, they thought that the temple is a cosmic being. Okay, so just like the human body parts, it has been in that order. The place where the presiding deity was worshipped, that place was called Garbhagriha, and just like a womb, the light there also is generally quite dim. Okay, so that is the Garbhagriha. The Pista, if you start from bottom to top, the Pista is not a compulsory feature of a Rekha temple. And generally, you will find it in the temples which were constructed during the Ganga period, the Ganga dynasty. They mainly built this. In many of the Rekha temples, Pista is absent. So, it is not a compulsory feature. The Bada, on the other hand, has three major elements. That is why it is called the Trianga Bada. Okay. Triangha means the three components. What are they? The Pabhaga, the Jangha, and the Baranda. And later on, when the temple architecture evolved, these three were again divided into five. That is Pabhaga, the Tala Jangha, the Bandhana, Upara Jangha, and the Baranda. So, the Pabhaga, that is the bottom part of the wall. And the Baranda, that is the topmost part of the Bada. After the Bada, the next part of a Rekha temple is the Gondi. And the Rekha temples, the Gondi is having a inward inclination, just like, you know, a convex curve. Then, as we had seen, it is divided into number of pagas or the vertical projections. Right? So, depending on which type of temple architecture has been followed, the number of pagas are there. So, if there is a three ratha plan, you have two types of pagas. There is a central projection that is known as the Rahapaga, and that has again the Rahapaga, that is the central projection, it has two other pagas, okay, known as the Karnika pagas on both the sides. And these were the initial temples, the temples in the formative phases. Next, with the evolution of the temple architecture, there were five pagas or panchapaga, pancharatha temples, right? To the existing three, two more pagas were added. That is the Anuratha Paga, which is between the Raha Paga and the Kanika Paga. Right? So, two pagas were added on either side. Then, again it evolved to the Shapta Ratha, and there another two pagas were added in between the Anuratha Paga and the Kanika Paga, known as the Anuraha. And finally, there were the Navaratha temples, in which the Pariraha Paga that were added on either sides between the Anuraha and the Kanika Pagas. So, you can see the, you know, with the evolution of the Kalingan school of architecture, the designs became more magnificent and more complex. So, starting from a Triratha architecture, we reached to a Navaratha architecture. Next, we come to the top of the temple, that is known as the Mastaka or the Sira, the head. That is now divided into five parts. First is the Bekki. Okay, just like, you know, we have our neck, that is in Odia, it is called Bekka. So, the Bekki. After that, the Amla, the Khapuri, which is basically the skull, the Kalasha or the water pot, and the Ayudha. Ayudha means the weapon of the presiding deity. And above the Ayudha, the Dhoja or the banner of the deity was placed at the pinnacle. So this was the order of the Mastaka. And if you see the most distinct example of Rekha Devula, or the Rekha temple, that is the Lingaraj temple of Bhubaneswar. Next we come to the second type of temple, that is the Pidha temple. So the starting from the beginning, the Bada is basically same like the Rekha temple. But the difference is in the Gondi. Okay, so as you can see in the figure which was shown on your screen earlier, the Gondi of the Jagamohana in the Pidha temple, it is of a pyramidal shape and it consists of number of Pidhas or horizontal platforms which rapidly decrease in size from bottom to top. So, That is basically the Pida temple. And above the Gondi, if you see the Mastaka, it's almost same as that of the Rekha temple, but one of the elements is there that is known as a Ghanta. Okay, that is the bell. Right? So, after the Bekki, the Ghanta comes and then it is the other common elements which were there in the Rekha temple. Like the Amla, Khapuri, Kalasa. Right? So, it's major difference between the Rekha temple and the Pida temple, that is in the Gondi, in the pyramidal structure instead of a curvilinear structure like we had seen in the Rekha temples. And the best example of a Pida temple is the Konark Sun temple. The next type is the Khakara type of temple, and it is completely different, quite distinguished. So, and it is mainly for the Shakti worship. So, the Gondi of the Khakara is either it's like a Rekha temple, that is curvilinear, or like a Pida temple, that is pyramidal. And the major difference is the plan of the temple is oblong, and its mastaka or the sira, it is distinguished by barrel vaulted elongated roofs called the Khakaras. Okay, and according to that, its name is the Khakara temples. Above the Khakara, there are the Amlas, which are flanked by lions. And if you want to see the examples of Khakara temple, then the Baital temple of Bhubaneswar, which is dedicated to Chamunda, that is a type of Khakara temple. The Brahmi temple of Chaurasi in Puri and the Gauri temple of Bhubaneswar, they are also Khakara temples. So, mainly the Shakti pithas, they are mainly of the Khakara type. These are the three major temple architectures of Odisha. Now, coming to the minor temple architectures. Other type of temples are also found in Odisha, like the Gauriya temples and the Hypethral temples. Now, the Gauriya temples are a synthesis of Indo-Aryan temple architecture and the Gothic style of temple architecture. And you can see the examples of such Gauriya temples in Mayurbhanj and also in Puri. Similarly, we also have the Hypethral temples, which is mainly the best example is the 64 Yogini temples. In Odisha, we have one near Bhubaneswar and one in Balangir. The ground plan is generally circular and they do not have roofs. So, in short, these are the various types of temple architectures which we find in Odisha. In the final lecture on temple architecture, what we will be concentrating on is the individual temples, important temples. We will analyze those. Thank you.